Hello everyone, I am Dr. Vishal Ramesh More, consulting chest physician. I am a consultant at KEM Hospital in Pune and Sahyadri Multispeciality Hospital near Kalyani Nagar, Nagar Road. And I practice in this Viman Nagar and Dhanuri area. So basically, I would like to tell that since 1951 or 1991, the average life expectancy has been increased. So, India has also been labeled by global survey as an aging country. So, we have lot of segment of people above 60 years of age because the medical facilities are good, they are improving. So, till 2050, we are suspecting that we should cross 234 million of people of more than 60 years of age. So obviously there are multiple chronic lung diseases which may happen in these people. The most common and deadliest disease is COPD, that is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. It is the second leading cause of the death in India in 2017, almost 1 million people. The next most common is the communicable diseases like tuberculosis, pneumonia, swine flu. And the third thing are the interstitial lung diseases, which are new diseases which are being identified early by the chest physicians nowadays. So it has many infectious, non-infectious causes. And the last thing is we can say that the GERD induced chronic cough. So that are some physiological changes and pathological changes also which causes this type of lung diseases in older people. Yes, definitely. I always say to all people, and older people also and young also, never take your respiratory system for granted. The most common symptoms you should never ignore is first is wheezing, that is whistling sound, chhati mein ghar ghar awaaz aana, ya phir CT jaisa bajna. When you have some breathlessness feeling after taking up stairs or walking some 100 meter distance, you should compare with your same age group people. Whether I am getting breathless more than the other one. Yes, that is something serious. If you have chronic cough, which is also intermittent, we label it as chronic bronchitis. Bronchitis means inflammation of the airway. So you may have chronic cough, then breathlessness, wheezing, some allergy, recurrent sneezing, recurrent upper respiratory tract infection. Usually people get sardi khasi jo bar bar hoti hai. So these are some common things which may early pick up the respiratory condition, underlying respiratory condition. So you should never ignore these symptoms. Yes, over-the-counter medications which all Indians are taking, easily available in pharmacy, you should definitely not take that. You should always consult your physician, because it has very drastic effects. People are taking acetylene spray over the round the clock. Thoda sa breathless feel hota hai, acetylene le leta hu, okay ho jata hai. But now the research has proved that acetylene spray is very dangerous for your health. People are dying because using of chronic acetylene spray, and it has been banned by WHO. So you should not use such kind of sprays, inhalers without any prescriptions. No any round the clock medications. People go and take normal medications, augmentin, acetylene. It has something issues, then you can take the medications after proper prescription. But people thoda bahut sardi khasi ho jata hai, azithromycin le lete hai. Overuse of these prescriptions may lead to resistance of antibiotics. Then at your after 50s, if you suffer from some infection or something disease, then basic antibiotics are not your choice because you are already resistant to those antibiotics. So very few options are left for antibiotics. So never ever use such self-prescribed medications. Sleep and respiratory system are definitely entangled with each other, because sleep and in sleep there are too many stages, 2 to 3, 4 stages, and respiratory system also has various effects on sleep, and sleep also have various effects on respiratory system. Your breathing issues, there are some central receptors, there are some receptors, they send signal to your brain when you are in deep sleep or light sleep, and accordingly the respiratory system adjusts its breathing. So that definitely gets hampered. Basically, in old age people, many geriatric people come to me that मुझे रात को नींद बहुत कम आती है. Some people say that I snore a lot in during my sleep. Some people say I have some choking sensation while sleeping. Yes, you may have sleep apneas, and that may definitely have some dreadful outcomes for your lungs and your whole system, because your diabetes may not be in control, your sugar, your thyroid, your weight gain, everything is out of control because you are not having some quality sleeps. As there are sleep apneas, your breaths are almost getting stopped for almost 10 seconds. That is, we call it apneas. So that is a really serious issues. We have many people that say neend mein hi chal base, so they must be having some sleep apneas. So yes, definitely it is interrelated, and you should take opinion of a chest physician for sleep study, and that is also home based sleep study. You have no need to get admitted anywhere. You can have home based sleep study, and awareness is very much important. There are too many questions and too many symptoms of sleep apneas. Chest physician will definitely solve your issues. Yes, definitely there are very much advances now happening in India and around the world also. Recently, I would like to add, lung transplant facility is also started in India. It is in Chennai in Global Hospital. For some ailments which don't have any cure, like end stage COPD, end stage asthma, interstitial lung diseases. Interstitial lung disease is a very broad term. So this kind of any congenital diseases like cystic fibrosis or alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, these conditions don't have treatment. The only treatment is lung transplant, and yes, it is available in India. The second thing is the bronchial thermoplasty. Yes, in uncontrolled asthma, bronchial thermoplasty is an investigation and a technique. It is therapeutic plus diagnostic also, and it is very useful for asthmatic people. Third thing is bronchoscopy, EBUS, that is endobronchial ultrasound. Bronchoscopy is just like endoscopy. We insert the camera inside your lungs. We check your whole lung airways. Whether it is something, any abnormality, we can just pick up that abnormality from your bronchoscope. So too many advanced functioning are there. And yes, the recent also force oscillometry technique, DLCO, single breath, that is diffusion capacity of your lung. How your lungs are functioning at your alveolar, that is air sac levels. That also we can determine everything. How is your gas exchange, how is your lung capacity, how you can work after walking for 6 minutes. All these tests are available in India. In Pune also it is available. So yes, definitely there are very much advancement going on here in lung system, in respiratory system also. And I would like to add, instead of too much focus on healthcare, we should develop a culture of health. Because whatever lifestyle we live during your young life, during your adolescent age, middle age, is less than 50 years of age, definitely the way we sit, the way we talk, the way we walk, the way we eat, and all the good and bad habits. Yes, definitely that is the culture. And whatever we change, whatever the culture we will change, that will affect in your late 60s. Definitely, culture of health is very important instead of healthcare.